Billionaire's brother presents him with an unusual gift. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe. Smash that like button, and ding that notification bell. Nick is a billionaire, but lives alone. Today's his 48th birthday, and his brother, Sean, whom he hasn't met for a long time, sends Nick a membership card to a game company as a birthday gift. He mysteriously told his brother that the card will definitely make him feel good. This year's birthday, Nick is actually very irritable inside, because his father jumped off the building to commit suicide on his 48th birthday. This incident has become a psychological shadow for half of Nick's life. He had talent and power, but was mean and indifferent and did not even have a friend around, and one day when he died, perhaps his brother Sean would be the only one to come to collect his body. Thinking of this, Nick was even sadder. Later, Nick took his membership card to the headquarters of the game company. The salesman who served him was named Jim. Jim asked a bunch of nonsense questions and did a whole day of mental and physical tests on Nick, which made Nick very impatient. When everything was done, he went to a bar alone for a drink, only to accidentally overhear two men at the next table discussing a game designed by this game company. Nick is curious and tries to ask what is going on, but the two men only tell him to enjoy. The next day he received a call from the game company. Due to the failure of the mental and physical tests, his game was cancelled. He returned home slightly frustrated and found a lying corpse in front of his villa in the exact same position as when his father jumped to his death. Nick carefully went up to check and realized that it was not a real corpse, but a clown puppet dressed in clothes. He dragged the clown home and pulled out a key in the interface with the word game company printed on it. Just then, the news anchor on TV suddenly tells Nick, "Brother, the game has officially begun." Nick is a bit confused, but he soon discovers the mystery. It turns out that the clown's eyes are equipped with cameras, so the news anchor can talk to him through the TV. The anchor finally told Nick mysteriously, "Brother, do not pursue the meaning of the game. The meaning is to find out the meaning behind it." The next day, Nick had to fire an old supervisor of the branch. The old supervisor had caused the company's stock to plummet because of bad decisions, which made Nick furious. The supervisor begged Nick to give himself another chance, but Nick immediately asked him to sign the termination contract. However, the suitcase containing the contract could not be opened. Nick pulled out the key obtained from the mouth of the clown, but still couldn't open the suitcase. The matter of layoff can only be discussed next time. At the dinner, Nick got splashed with red wine by a waitress. The waitress, Nana, had just come to work at the restaurant, and Nick, who was in a bad mood, could not help but scold at her. The restaurant manager, to please Nick, fired Nana on the spot and said this meal can be free of charge. Who knows, after the manager just left, another waiter handed over a bill. Nick felt puzzled, but after reading the bill, he panicked and rushed out to catch up with Nana. He asked what the bill was about, but Nana was even more baffled and didn't want to talk to Nick. Just as the two walked to the intersection, an old man suddenly fell in front of them both. Nick, though, thought something was abnormal, still called the emergency number. A police car happened to pass by. Nick rushed forward to stop it. The ambulance also then arrived. The police let Nick and Nana get into the car, accompanied the old man to the hospital. They also needed to make a simple statement. Nick took out the bill to explain why he had chased Nana. It turns out the bill says to let Nana go as well, which she guesses is part of the game. Nana blanks Nick for being downright old-fashioned in this way of finding girls to pick up. Soon they arrived at the hospital's parking lot and the old man is transferred into the emergency room. Just as Nick and Nana are ready to leave, the garage suddenly lost power and all the medical staff and police around them instantly disappeared, plunging the large space into total darkness. It seems like the game company is behind it again, so Nick told Nana about his participation in the live game. Nana doubted it. Nick saw a keyhole on the elevator, and once again pulled out the key on his body, and it really worked. The elevator suddenly got stuck halfway through, and they had to climb out through the skylight to find out that this was the headquarters of the game company. Nick was so annoyed and couldn't help to curse. The security guards did not say anything, directly let the dog bite them. The two rushed over the fence and jumped into a dumpster to escape safely, seeing Nana being innocently involved in because of him. And he also made a mess. Nick felt quite sorry. He invited her to his company's lounge to clean up before going home. After Nana took a shower, Nick thoughtfully called a cab for her. Surprisingly, Nana frankly told Nick that someone paid her to splash red wine on him. Nick laughed at this. The next day, Nick woke up and received a call from a hotel, telling him that his bank card was left in the hotel. Nick was confused and came to the front desk of the hotel to get his card. Politely said that the room had been opened for him. Nick did not remember opening a room at all, but after in the pockets, he found a room card and decided to see it. Nick found the room extremely messy. There was some unknown white powder and a bunch of racy photos of women. The woman in the photos did not show her face. Nick panicked and flushed the white powder into the toilet, and put all the photos into the briefcase next to it. He suspected that this incident was the work of the old supervisor who was going to be fired. This guy even faked Nick's sex scandal to threaten him. Nick drove out of the hotel in a hurry to get his revenge. Nick was followed on the way and led the stalker into an alley and found his personal information and a pistol in the car. Nick asked him if he was sent to follow him, but the person left the car and escaped. Distracted, Nick went to the old supervisor to get his revenge but found that the supervisor already resigned and even signed the termination contract. It seems that the matter was again made by the game company, and Nick has had enough of this inexplicable game. He went back to the company and flipped out the game and signed the option letter before he started, because the game company promised that the player could terminate the game at any time. However, Nick found the contract is blank. It seems that the words on it written in invisible ink, which will disappear without a trace once the time was up. Nick also found a wrench in the envelope and he put the wrench in his pocket. As Nick thought back carefully what he encountered on the days, he suddenly remembered the woman in those racy photos. Even though he couldn't see her face, the red underwear is still very eye-catching. And Nick accidentally saw Nana wearing the same underwear while she was taking a shower in the lounge. Thinking of this, he asked his subordinates to call the cab company to find out Nana's home address. At night, Nick returned to his house and found the power had been cut off and the walls were painted, and the clown had a picture of his father's death scene stuffed in his mouth, and a note writing, "As my father did, I choose to sleep long." This is not only rubbing salt in Nick's wounds but also abetting his committed suicide. He immediately called the police, and his brother Sean suddenly appeared before the situation was completely described. Sean looked terrified, invited Nick to get into the car and apologize that he shouldn't have let his brother play such a real-life game. He himself also participated in this game, but it led him to a mental breakdown. He tried to spend money to end it all, but it simply did not work. The company asked him to keep playing. The real purpose is unknown. Just now, the car suddenly blew a tire. They stopped at the side of the road. Nick then find a tool to get out of the car to replace the spare tire. As soon as they open the locker, a lot of keys all printed with the name of the company fell out. This time, Sean can no longer calm down. He actually suspected that the brother is also from the game company. Nick rushed to catch up, but Sean excitedly stopped to rebuke, hoping Nick not to meddle and mind his own business. Nick is usually very controlling, which Sean has long been dissatisfied with this. Then, Sean ran away again. Nick, physically and mentally exhausted, just stopped a cab to go home, but the driver gradually deviated from the route and drove directly into the river. Nick then realized that the driver was also from the game company, and the driver locked all the doors before jumping out of the car. Nick followed the car into the river. At the critical moment, he found a wrench in his pocket and eventually used it to open the car door and escape. After getting out of danger, Nick called the police again, but the game company headquarters has already been empty. The police did not find any clues, and were not willing to intervene in the investigation. After all Nick encountered are the result of his own boredom. He can no longer count on the police. Luckily, his assistant's side soon found out Nana's address. Nick came to Nana's house. When Nana went to the bathroom, he looked around and found that the room was not right. The label on the table lamp hadn't been removed. Even the books on the shelves were empty shelves. The pictures of Nana as a child were actually cut out from random newspapers. Nick directly asked Nana about what was going on. Nana whispered to remind him that there were cameras on the roof of the fire sprinkler. Nick smashed the cameras in anger. Sudden someone shot from outside. A group of masked killers directly killed over. Nick and Nana panicked, drove to escape. On the way, Nana finally confessed that she was an ordinary employee of a game company. This company specializes in recruiting wealthy members in the name of the game, with the aim of extracting wealth from the players. They will drive players crazy step by step through the game and finally kill them. Nana also reminded Nick to check his bank balance. Nick did not believe this. He thought his account was very safe, but Nana went on to remind him if he had done a lot of tests and signed a lot of papers before the game started. This is how the game company deduces the player's account number and password and imitates the player's signature. Then, they take away all the deposits. It was the only point that made Nick panic. At Nana's prompt, he dialed the bank and reported her account and password. The bank staff told Nick that his account does not have a penny. It seems that some companies really have a conspiracy. Nick drove Nana to his country house. Nana made hot tea for Nick. A few time later, Nick passed out then. It seems that Nana had put drugs in the tea. The game company speculated that the player account number and password are all bullshit. Why they asked Nick to call to check the accounts is to get the password and account. When Nick woke up, he found himself lying in a broken coffin. After he struggled to climb out, he realized that he was in Mexico. He was penniless and had no passport. But luckily, he still had a watch in his hand. This was a gift from his father before he died. Nick cherished it very much, but now he has had no choice, so he had to sell the watch and take a stolen car back. As soon as he arrived in the United States, he returned home. Nick got the news that his brother Sean was put in a mental hospital, and his own big villa was seized. Nick took a hot shower and then found a pistol as a weapon. With his brother Sean locked up in a mental hospital, Nick suddenly realizes that there is no one else in the world who can help him. He used to think he was rich and powerful, but now he realizes he actually has nothing. Finally, Nick thinks of his ex-wife. She lent Nick her car despite the past. Deep inside the heart, Nick felt infinite guilt towards his ex-wife, and he wanted to say sorry to her. Just then, a commercial actor on TV caught Nick's attention. This person was actually the receptionist of the game company Jim. Jim's turned out to be an actor. According to this clue, Nick soon found Jim. He directly pulled out a pistol to coerce Jim to take himself to find the person behind the crime. Jim took Nick to the headquarters of the game company, and they found the entire building is the property of the game company. The company's new headquarters is full of people. They wear the costumes of all lives as if they're ready to act. Nick saw Nana in a corner, and he quietly went over and directly took Nana as hostage with a gun. With the discovery of the security guards, regardless of Nana's death, raised the gun to shoot Nick. Nick took Nana all the way to the rooftop, and then locked the door to the rooftop. Now he is taking his revenge with Nana. Nana once again claimed that everything was really just a game. Nick's money was still in the account. All the shootings were all blanks and firecrackers faked out for special effects. Everything was an elaborate design by the company, and Nick's brother and colleagues have prepared him for a birthday party. How could Nick ever believe in this? Just then, the people inside began to cut the door lock with a chainsaw. Nick suspected that behind the door was a group of loaded killers, and he turned his gun to prepare for the last wave. Nana was completely panicked. She reassures Nick while telling the people behind the door through the walkie-talkie in her hand not to act rashly because Nick has a real gun in his hand. But it's too late. The door opened at the same time. Nick also pulled the trigger, and after a gunshot, Sean, who was surrounded by the crowd, fell to the ground dead from the gunshot. The only family member actually died under Nick's own gun. Nick was heartbroken. In a daze, he went the rooftop and jumped from the roof. Just like what his father did, in the few seconds he fell, his mind recalled his childhood. He remembered his father's smiling arms around himself, remembered his open arms hugging his brother who was still a baby. A few seconds later, Nick fell heavily but he didn't die. Instead of a hard floor, he was greeted by a soft, giant air cushion. In front of him was a lively party scene, and it was his own birthday party. This is exactly his own birthday party. Sean came through the crowd and sincerely offered birthday wishes to his brother. It seems that the brother's fake death and Nick's jump were both game sessions designed by the game company. He was not angry when he learned the final truth, and when he jumped down, he was reborn. The shadow of his father's suicide seemed to have dissipated in his mind, and he began to realize that earning money is not the only thing in life. Perhaps the relationship between people is the code for long-term happiness. This is probably the breakdown therapy in the mental theory. At the end of the story, the brother pays a huge amount of money for Nick to end this thrilling psychological game. Nick also catches up with Nana, who is ready to leave at the last minute, to extend an invitation to her for a date. Subscribe for more videos like this.